Should you get the Arduino UNO R4 Minima or should you get the Arduino R4 Wi-Fi? Maybe skip both? You might think it's just a Minima with Wi-Fi, but there is actually a lot more going on. Let's dive in and find out. R4 Minima and R4 Wi-Fi are the latest generation of Arduino's UNO family. First up, let's talk power and specs. Is the jump worth the price? R4 Minima is already packed with a lot of new features. R4 Wi-Fi adds a Qwiic connector, an LED matrix, a Wi-Fi and Bluetooth module, and a real-time clock battery pin. The Minima runs on 48 MHz 32-bit CPU with 32 kilobytes of SRAM and 256 kilobytes of flash memory, while the Wi-Fi features a dual-core CPU with up to 240 MHz, 512 kilobyte SRAM and 8 megabytes of flash memory. You might be thinking, well, that's a big leap, but there's a catch. This power is sadly locked away in the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth module. The main CPU stays the same, kind of like buying a high-end gaming PC just to send some emails. So with all this extra hardware, let's compare the current consumption of these boards. Running the basic Blink example, the R4 Minima sips between 20 and 30 milliamps. But the R4 Wi-Fi, let's find out. Well, let me show you this animation again. This actually reminds me of a project that I'm working on for quite a while now, something I'm excited to share soon. But back to our R4 Wi-Fi. Yes, it draws way more current. Some of you might think it's the LED matrix, right? Running basic Blink again, the consumption stays high, likely thanks to the Wi-Fi module. But now let's upload a Wi-Fi sketch that scans for nearby networks. And as expected, the current draw goes way up. Another fun part is if we upload the basic Blink again, the current consumption stays high until you fully cut the power. Seems like ESP32 doesn't like to go back to sleep. Oh, and that shiny LED matrix. You think it uses the ESP32 for extra processing power, right? Right? Nope. They connected it directly to the Renesas, meaning no dedicated LED driver and an extra load on an already modest CPU. Not so great. R4 Wi-Fi also features a real-time clock battery pin. I tried to find out the information on which battery to connect. However, I wasn't able to find this information on the Arduino website. But looking into the schematic, it is directly connected to the Renesas chip. Looking into the datasheet of Renesas, looks like the recommended voltage is between 1.6 and 3.6 volt when the battery backup function is used, which I guess is the reason why we use it. So yeah, it should work fine with one of these 3 volt cell batteries or two of your standard AA batteries. So it has a real-time clock, it has Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, it has a display. Technically, it would make a great smartwatch. Dang it. Not great, not terrible. Yeah, I think I'll stick to my Garmin for now. R4 Wi-Fi also comes with diagnostics for runtime errors. I thought, wow, finally it's time to set a breakpoint, press debug, and no, actually not. Looking through the documentation, it looks like we can use the serial connection to debug runtime errors using stack trace. So we will get back detailed information on why it crashed. Not bad. Moving on to the Qwiic connector. Perfect for adding accessories without the risk of reversing the supply voltage, like I did in my Sauron video. But seriously, this connector is great. there are a lot of modules on the market, it's easy plug and play. Now, one final thing to look at is the Arduino Cloud. Arduino Cloud lets you manage your Arduino Uno over the air. You can update code, you can log data, and you can monitor your sensors, everything online over the air. They also have a free plan to try it out, but I have to admit, I really like to keep things local and to keep full control over my devices. So in my case, I would prefer using a local MQTT broker and Home Assistant, which is free, open source, very flexible, and works great. So to sum up this video, if you need easy to access Wi-Fi, a reliable real-time clock, a Qwiic connector, and maybe a display to show some numbers, the R4 Wi-Fi is a great choice. An Arduino Cloud may be just what you need for a Qwiic setup. As for me, I stick with wired solutions like my smart home sensor utilizing power over Ethernet and ESP32. If you're interested in this stuff, check out this playlist. If you're interested in game development, I've got something better coming soon. Like, subscribe, and check out this video to find out if it's better to stick to Arduino Uno R3. You might be surprised. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.